Hello, dear viewer, and welcome back to this Let's Play of Star Wars Knights of the Old Republic on the iPad. This is Karth, sporting some new implants, apparently, which, yeesh, I guess that is comfortable? I really don't know. Regardless, we finished getting the swoop bike accelerator, and apparently I started a conversation by accident. Yay. Sure. We'll lead with Jalanon the Tank. Through the sewers once more. We're going to try and go up back to the outcast city because it turns out we have a quest to turn in. Oh wait, this is back to the base. Whoops. Okay. And back. So yes. One more trek through the sewage and scum. I mean, if we were trying to quote Star Wars here, we could say, through this wretched hive of scum and villainy, but I don't know. I feel like there's not too many villains left down here, since we kind of delivered justice everywhere. So, yeah. Let's just run to the sewers. You know what? Let me double check the rapid transit system. It looks like we can only really go back to our hideout quickly. I've been trying to mess with it and see if there were any other ways to move fast through the maps, but nope. I guess this way we won't miss out on any experience if any mobs or enemies or whatever you want to call them respawn. So there is that. Yes. Other than that, we'll just have a quick little jog. Oh wait, did we not explore this one? Oh, I guess it just won't fill in because we can't go over there. Okay, check the map. There's a force field to the Undercity. Undercity. Gamorrean compound. Wait, have we actually... It looks like we've been through there. I'd never noticed that on the map before. Let's check it out, yo. Okay, there's a frag mine.
Yes, what's on your mind?
No, Karth.
You got it.
Okay. Yeah, we're not really using mission on our team right now. We could switch out and try to game the system a bit, but no real point. We're just going to beat up the bad guys. Unless, of course, they're Rancors that we have to outsmart. Let's attack. Improved rapid shot. And you... Yeah, just flurry.
Time to rumble!
There we go. Okay, so... Oh. There are... Oh, Karth, no! Okay. Run! Oh, shoot. No, not the adrenal stuff. We need antidote kit. Then we need the med pack. What do we need? To shoot some bad guys. / mutants who really can't control themselves, but we really can't trust not to eat us. So, sad day, yo. Wow, the background music seems pretty loud right now. Maybe that was just because of combat. Oh well. So, I guess nothing new from that area, so we'll just head back up. Yoink. And marching we will go through the sewers to and fro. Back to this place where the outcasts do roam. And if I can make up other words, we'll sing those too. Okay. Now we want to find Rukil in this outcast city, apparently. If I remember correctly, he's... Yeah, at his tent. That might make sense. Okay, we'll go to the village gate, which is the green spot on the map. Yay. And it also highlights for us. Yeah, we can get some free healing while here, so goodness yes, we're going to do that. Let's say Ruko's tent is down there. And where's the healer? I think the healer is over to the right. So, we'll go this way. Well, I've been wrong before, and I guess I'm wrong now. Sad day. Ah, Karth seems to be bothered by something. Perhaps it's his blue headphones. Probably not.
Yes, what's on your mind?
Let's continue our discussion.
I thought I said I don't want to talk about it anymore.
Don't you think you'd feel better if you discussed it?
Not particularly. I guess it wouldn't hurt exactly either, though I don't know why you're so interested. When I think of all the men who betrayed us, the one that stands out above all of them is the one that I respect the most, Saul.
You say that name like I should know it.
You don't. I thought everyone did. But Admiral Saul Carath is the commander of the entire Sith fleet. He's half the reason Malak has done so well in the war. Saul was my commanding officer back when the Mandalorian Wars first began. He taught me everything about being a soldier, and I looked up to him. Saul approached me before he left. He talked to me about how the Republic was on the losing side and about how I should start thinking of my survival. I know now that he was trying to recruit me into the Sith, but I couldn't have conceived of it back then. I argued with him and he got angry and he left. I never saw him again.
You didn't think he would betray the Republic?
Saul was my mentor. He led us to so many victories against the Mandalorians. Even when things looked to be at the worst, I couldn't conceive of it. He couldn't be serious. I was wrong, of course. He not only left us for the Sith, he gave them the codes to bypass our scanners. I remember waking up as the first of the Sith bombers snuck past our defenses and began destroying half of our docked ships. I knew right away where it happened. I mean, I could have stopped him. I could have stopped it all.
So you blame yourself for trusting your friend?
I blame Saul, not myself. I was stupid and I ignored the danger. He nearly destroyed us all. I fought Saul for years now, and if I ever catch up to him, he will regret what he's done. He will regret it.
So that's all of it, then?
No, it's not. But I don't want to talk about it right now. Let's go.
Okay, Karth. Well, we'll give him a break from his emotions. Let him work through it. Oh, there's that healer. She was down and to the right.
You amaze me. I always thought the surface dwellers couldn't care less about us outcasts, but you risked everything to help those infected villagers. I wish I had some type of reward to give you, but we outcasts have nothing. All I can offer is the gratitude of the entire village.
I need healing. I'd call that pretty good gratitude.
You got it.
I mean, healing's pretty important. Let's see. Ruko.
Greetings once more, Upworlder. Do you bring news of my apprentice? Have you discovered her fate and proved yourself to be a true savior of my people?
Your apprentice is dead. I have her journal. Condolences? Man, this is kind of cut and dry. Wow.
It is as I feared, then. She joins the list of those who have given their lives in the service of our cause. But though I am saddened by this news, there is yet hope. By finding my apprentice, you have proved yourself worthy, Upworlder. You are to be the beacon on our path to salvation. You will guide us to the Promised Land.
Guide you? But I don't even know where the Promised Land is.
You are marked, Upworlder. Even my dim old eyes can see the mantle of destiny that cloaks you. Perhaps old Rukil knows you better than you know yourself. I am old. I have lived 100 years in the Undercity, cast down into the darkness. I know the legends and history of our people, and now you must learn it too.
Very well.
The great city of Taris covers the entire surface of this planet. There is no land to grow food. Kelp harvests and the creatures of the sea are our only food source. A century ago, Rising levels of toxic pollution poisoned the oceans, and famine swept the planet. The rich hoarded food for their own use, and the poor were left to starve and die.
From what I've seen of Terras, it doesn't look like much has changed. Except for the upper city, people here are just as bad off as the poor in your little history.
But the poor rose up against this tyranny, and civil war engulfed the planet. Millions died in the fighting, and huge sections of Taras were destroyed or abandoned. The rebellion was crushed in the end. Thousands were taken prisoner. The jails could not hold them all, and so the practice of banishing all prisoners to the Undercity was born.
Is that how you came to be down here?
Many brave men and women were banished here to the Undercity for their part in the rebellion. People like my father and grandfather were cast down, along with their families. Now we live a dark existence beneath the streets of Terras, a life devoid of all hope but one, the Promised Land. And you will be the one to show us the way to get there.
The Promised Land?
Legends tell of a self-sufficient colony founded just before the famine and lost during the Civil War. A paradise beneath the Undercity, where droid servants tend to every knee. For many years, I searched for the Promised Land, just as my grandfather and father did before me. When I became old and gray, my apprentice continued the search on my behalf.
Sounds like a myth to me. Something to give the people here some false hope to cling to so they don't go mad with despair.
I have collected many clues hinting at its location. The journal of my apprentice provides yet more information. But still, there are too many pieces missing from this puzzle. But I know my father and grandfather each had journals where they recorded their own discoveries.
Dun, dun, dun.
With their journals, I could at last uncover its hidden location.
Ooh. Well, I have one of the journals, apparently.
Yes, Upworlder. Well done. However, I see that this journal alone does not have enough clues for me to solve this mystery. Too many pieces are still missing. I'm afraid that only with all three journals, my grandfather's, my father's, and my apprentice's, will I be able to discover the location of the Promised Land. I will leave this journal with you for safekeeping for now. Perhaps it will aid you in your search for the others. I wish you luck, Upworlder. For the sake of the entire village.
Fetch quest. Huh. You know, I never did read that journal. Promised Land. Curse. Okay. Okay. Where are you, journal? Okay, it just has the last entry. Oh, okay. So we do have to search the sewers more closely. One day. That day is not this day. Unless Gindar has any, you know, like, stuff.
Few from the surface would bother to cure an outcast of the Rakul disease as you have done. My only regret is that I have no reward to give you for your aid, save my thanks and the thanks of my people.
And, you know, healing.
Ask your questions, Upworlder.
Ah, about the Promised Land.
Ah, you have been speaking with Rukil. I'm afraid the Promised Land is nothing but a legend. If such a place existed, it surely would have been found by now. Rukil is a good man, but he's old and tired. He needs to cling to his illusion to keep... Ask your questions,
Upworlder.
As you wish, Upworlder.
Okay. So, Gindar doesn't have any info. Anyway, let's head back to the Hidden Back. We want to become a Jedi at some point, so we want to continue the main story. Okay, where am I going? Right, that way. Debris! The one impediment I cannot surmount. Well, I thought I was this way. Oh, elevator. Well then. So was that just the tent? Yes. Okay. That's the sewers. There's the escape pod. Sewers. Okay. Lower city should be up here. Ah. I'm just blind. Okay.
Hey, you've already shown me you're suggesting
Yeah, I just thought, you know, you might say something new. I'm sorry, Sith Soldier. Your cool armor doesn't give you more quotes. Oh well. To the hidden back. They're kind of like the Robin Hood gang of the city. Slash, not really, but hey, they're not killing everybody inside, so they're better than the Black Volker. So we are going to get an awesome swoop bike engine to them. Yoink. I wonder if Zalbar will have anything fun to say. Zalbar. Get to expend yourself. No. Okay, Gatton. Where are you? There you are.
You have returned. You have the prototype swoop engine accelerator with you?
I have the accelerator.
I was beginning to wonder if you would make it. The race is tomorrow, and my mechanics need time to install the prototype into the swoop engine of our bike.
Okay, I lived up to my end of the deal.
Don't worry. I'm a man of my word. I promised you could ride in the swoop race under the Hidden Beck banner, and I'm still going to let you do that. And I'm even going to go one better. I'm going to let you ride the swoop bike with the prototype accelerator installed on it. Without it, you won't stand a chance.
Gatton, you can't be serious. We need one of our best riders on that bike. We can't let some rookie take the prototype engine into the race.
Don't worry, Gatton. I'll win that race.
I have to be honest with you. There's a reason I'm letting you take the prototype engine. The accelerator is at stake. There's a good chance it could explode during the race. I can't ask one of my own riders to take the risk. They'll be running unmodified swoops in the race. You'll be the only one using the prototype. If you can complete the track before
Thank
the
you for your concern.
Overheats, then you'll win for the Becks. If you die, then one of my other riders could still come through for me.
Well, that sounds like a Xanatos gambit where you don't lose either way. Sounds like you got all your bases covered.
You don't get to be leader of a swoop gang if you don't know how to work all the angles.
Okay, I'm ready for the race.
You can stay here tonight. The mechanics need time to install the accelerator on the engine, so you won't be able to practice your riding. But I've got good instincts, and you have the look of a racer about you. Just try to relax, and in the morning we'll take you to the swoop track.
You spend a restless night in the Beck base. In the morning, one of the Becks takes you to the swoop racing pits, where only racers and mechanics are allowed to go. So, yeah. Loading. Unloading. And this guy's saying, so you're the one who's going to ride this swoop bike, eh? Don't worry, I've been working on the accelerator and stability won't be a problem, I hope. Gatton mentioned that you've never done this before. You want me to run over the basics of handling a swoop bike for you? Yes, yes I do. Please. Apparently it's pretty simple. First, try not to crash into anything. There's debris and obstacles, so watch out for those. Great. If only I had a controller for this part. All swoops are equipped with a dynamic deflector system, so hitting an obstacle won't cause you to crash, but will shake you up a bit and slow you down. The slow part is what I'm worried about. Oh, accelerator panels are built into its surface of the track. If you fly over one, it'll give your swoop a boost of speed. When the engine starts running hot, you'll get a warning and you'll have to switch gears. Other than that, just try to hang on. Okay, let's start the race and see if I fail horribly, I guess. Yay. Okay, Oh, he says, hold on, I better explain the rules to you. Each rider goes out on the track alone. At the end of the day, whoever posts the fastest time is the winner. Normally a rider can run as many heats as they want, but I don't know how long the prototype accelerator and super will hold up. No more than 4 or 5 races, I'd guess. So make your runs count. Okay. I won't let you down. Okay, so now we go talk to the race announcer. That probably won't happen in terms of explosions. Great. Quick save. Okay. Well, Firk, do you have anything to say for yourself? Basically, he's saying, we don't want rookies to die. Yeah, she just reiterated it might explode. Okay, so he's just talking trash. Yeah, he's also talking trash. What about this guy? Oh, dang. Neural disruptor collar on Bastila. And we're not allowed to talk to her, so great. Okay, one more quick save, just because. And race announcer. Okay, only one guy has died so far, and he likes the Hidden Vex over the Black Volkers, so we should be fine. What's the time to beat? 38 seconds. Okay. What happened to the rider you lost? Oh, yeah, he fell off the swoop bike. They scraped what was left of him off the track already. Wonderful. Just remember to hang on. Good advice. Hang on. Tap once to accelerate and shift gears. Swipe left and right to avoid obstacles and hit accelerator pads. So you have to tap to start. So I wish they'd said that, but okay. Okay, and you have to hold when you swipe. So, oh wait, am I missing all the accelerator pads? I am. Great. This does require some concentration, but it's not. Oh, I take that. I was going to say it's not terrible, but. Wait, did I just? Okay. I think I just won. Well, that wasn't too bad. That's right. Noobs for the win! Okay. Someone who's never ridden a swoop before today comes in here and... Wait a minute. I don't believe this. Look at the board. One of the Volkers just beat your time. Who? Ah, it was Redros. I should have known. What? Okay. So, I should have gone slower, I guess. So then, I wouldn't have to beat my own best time. Interesting. I wonder if we can game the game. I want to race one of my heats. Oh, actually, what's the time to beat? I wonder if there is a point where he simply can't beat you. And I'm going to continuously tap the screen as we start. Oh, right, I forgot to tap occasionally to change gear. You want to do that when it's too hot. Yeah, it seems like the accelerator... Oh. Oh, well. I think the accelerator pads might actually reset the gear so you don't have to tap the screen in order to keep switching. No, it's so much worse. Oh well. experimentation, I suppose. Good run, good run. You didn't post the top time, but that's okay. I checked out your swoop, and you should be okay for a few more runes, at least. Remember, avoid the obstacles. Hit the accelerator plates on the track and switch gears when the engine revs get high. Don't worry, you'll get that top time yet. I know you won't let us down. Now get back out on that track and show these punks how to ride. Alright, let's give it that good old college try. Third time's the charm. Back again, I see. So are you ready to hit the track? Not literally, of course. We've already lost one rider that way today. Yep. He just repeats himself, I suppose. Alright. No talking time. Okay. So it seems if you don't hit any of the things that slow you down, then it will not need the tap to reset the gear. Oh, in 20 years I've never seen anybody handle a swoop like that before. And I'm sure Gaddon will in fact, or not Gaddon. Oh. Okay, wow. I guess he can't be 27. That's right. Through my skill and courage, I have brought glory to the Hidden Beck gang, apparently. I become the premier swoop rider on Terrace. Now here to present the champion's prize, Bregic, leader of the Black Volkers.
People, hear me! Before I present the so-called champion of the Becks with their prize, there is something you must know. The winning rider cheated.
You're a bleep liar, Bregic. A bleep liar.
Your swoop is using a prototype accelerator. Clearly an unfair advantage. Because of this hidden Beck treachery, I'm withdrawing the Volker's share of the victory prize.
You can't do this, Bregic. You know the rules. Nobody's allowed to withdraw a victory prize after the race. It goes against all our most sacred traditions.
Blah, 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 blah. You fool. Your traditions are nothing to me. I am the way of the future. If I want to withdraw the prize and sell this woman on the slave market myself, nobody can stop me.
I might have something to say about that, Bregic.
Oh.
What? Impossible. You were restrained by a neural disruptor. How could you have possibly summoned the will to free yourself?
You underestimate the strength of the Jedi's mind, Bregic. A mistake you won't live to regret.
Focus to me! Kill this woman!
Dang.
Kill the swoop rider! Kill them all!
Alright, so... You know what? Let's make this a big episode. Let's see. We've got Bregic, we've got Volker, Redros. Oh, Dopa's not attacking us, but Redros is. Strange. Well, everyone, it's time to take down Bregic. And apparently, I am currently alone. Wonderful. Let's go for the big hitter first. Let's attack normally for a while. Looks like Bastil is going to help me, so that's nice. Okay, so he has quite a bit of health. Okay. We're going to go for this guard then. Never mind. Looks like the hidden decks are helping us out.
Power attack!
Oh, what? That was a good dodge. Oh my gosh. Okay, fine, we'll attack Redros. Well, I guess not. Well, looks like we're all attacking Bredrick. Okay. But until that happened. Goodbye, Bredrick. Oh, come on. Engage. There we go. Alright, we have Bastila. Free, safe and sound, in the middle of a very distressing pile of corpses. Ta-da! Well, everyone, I hope you enjoyed this episode of Star Wars Knights of the Old Republic. Next time, what do we do with Bastila?